Hi, this is Amy from the Altiz store. I'm going to do a quick demo of how to wire multiple solar panels in parallel using a combiner box. Now, we've already done a video on how to wire panels in series and how to wire only two panels together in parallel using couplers. Now, this is going to be how to wire multiple panels together using a combiner box. Advantage of the combiner box is it does give you a way to disconnect the array if you're using breakers. Also, it lets you separate the two strings from each other in case something bad happens to one of the strings. It's not going to backfeed and damage the other strings. Really important if you've got more than two solar panels that you're wiring together. Now, we've got a display here that only has two panels, so we're going to be doing two parallel strings of one in series. But what we're showing you would be true as well if you had 12 panels all in series. You're going to be taking the plus from one panel in the string and the minus from the other, because when you wire in series, you're going to end up with one with plus, one with minus. And so this, because I've just got one, I only have one panel with the plus and the minus. So first thing you need to do is figure out if you've got connectors on the solar panel, what kind of connectors they are. I've got some older panels here, so they have the non-locking MC connectors, also known as MC1. They're made by Multi-Contact. They were very, very popular before 2008. If you've got newer panels, you may have connectors that have locks on them. So with them, you would have a little tab that would lock the connectors together, and you need a key to disconnect them. National Electric Code required that you have a locking connector for any accessible solar panels after 2008. So most manufacturers did switch over. So again, if you've got an older panel, you may have the MC. If you've got a newer panel, you may have a locking one. Now, several different manufacturers make these locking connectors, so you need to take a look and figure out what brand they are, because they're not all 100% interchangeable. So they might have the logo of the company written right on it. It might say MC or Tyco or Amphenol. If it doesn't, check out the data sheet of the solar panel you have. You can usually find those online, even for older, obsolete panels. They tend to still have the connector on the data sheet. So the reason you need that is because you're going to have these solar panels with the wire coming off them and have these solar connectors. Now, these connectors are really nice for wiring in series because they just click together. But now when you're wiring in parallel, you actually have to transition from these connectors to a bare stripped wire to go into your breaker box. So what you would do is you get an extension cable, and you're going to get the cable that's twice as long as you need it to be, the distance that you need to go, and you're going to have the correct connectors on it that you've already figured out what kind they are. You're going to cut it in two. Now, note I didn't say cut it in half. Now, since I'm just going from one panel, yeah, I'm going to cut them in half because they're both going to be going the same distance. But if I'm doing a string of panels, I might have the one panel really close to the combiner box and the other one kind of far away. So you don't want to just automatically go, whoop, cut it in two and find out one's too long, one's too short. It's a lot easier to cut than stretch, so you want to make sure you cut them the right size. And so what I've done here is I've cut the two, stripped it. I'm then going to take off the cover, and I'm going to remove the protective faceplate. Now, you see it's got a nice faceplate, so I can access the breakers, but not get my fingers where they shouldn't be. But now I take that off so that I can get in there. And you see I've got two breakers in here. I've got two strings that I'm wiring in parallel, so I have two breakers. Now, to figure out the size of the breaker, you need to check the data sheet or the label on the back of the solar panel, and it will tell you either the max series fuse size, or if it doesn't have that, it'll tell you the short circuit current, ISC. Now, that'll be in amps. You're going to take that, the ISC, times 1.56, and that will give you the minimum amps that your breaker needs to be, all right? So anything pretty much 140 watts and higher, the common ones tend to be a 15 amp or maybe even a 20 amp breaker, but figure it out. It'll either say it, max series string size, string fuse size, or the ISC times 156. So I'm going to take my two wires. Now I'm going to label these wires, the cut end of the wires, red for plus and white for minus, because NEC says a grounded, negative grounded system is going to be marked with white. I'm going to bring them in through a strain relief. Now, a strain relief gives me a nice watertight way to get into my combiner box. I'm going to take the plus and go to the bottom of one of my fuse, my breakers. And I'm going to tighten that up nicely. Then I'm going to take my negative and go to my negative bus bar. And tighten that up well. So I've now got the plus from one of my strings going to the bottom of the breaker. I've got the negative from that string going to the negative bus bar. Now I've already, just for simplicity, I've already wired up my second string. So I have my second string, the negative going to the negative bus bar and the positive going to its own breaker. The output of the breakers is going to this positive bus bar. It's a finger bus bar that generally comes with the combiner box. So that combines the output of the breakers. So it's protecting your breakers, it's protecting your wires, and it is combining the output of the breakers. Now I've also got a lightning arrestor to give me insurance against some nearby lightning strikes. And that is going to do the plus up to the positive bus bar, the minus to the negative bus bar, and the ground to my grounding bus bar. See, that's tucked back in here. I've also got my ground coming from my racking that's also bonded through my grounded mid clamps going through the wire up to my grounding bus bar. So I've got a nice wired, all grounded system. And so I'm now going to, with my breakers off, I'm going to connect them together. So I've got my cable going to string one and my cable going to string two. So now I'm going to be leaving the combiner box in conduit and go through conduit into the inside of my house or barn or wherever I've got my the rest of my system. So I'm going to go into my breaker box, my DC load center in there, all in conduit. And then once I've got that all wired up and all tested and make sure everything's good, then I'm going to be turning on my breakers. Now remember, when you have these breakers off, the output of the breakers, no, there's no power to it. But the input, as long as there's sun on those solar panels, there's still going to be power. So you want to be careful. Don't be lulled into a false sense of security that, oh, my breakers are off, there's no power in here. If there's sunlight on these panels, there's going to be power from between the negative bus bar and the bottom of the breakers. So just be careful. All right. Well, I hope this was helpful to you. If you liked it, give us a like and a share and subscribe to our channel at Alti Store so we'll notify you of more videos coming out. Also, go to our website at altistore.com, where we've been making renewable doable since 1999.